Welcome back to Exotic Car Playplace, everyone. Thanks for joining in on this beautiful sunny afternoon. Today we're going to talk about finding yourself a BMW with a reliable engine. A lot of you guys out there are worried. There's lots of reputations out there that precede the fact that a lot of the modern day BMWs, while they're some of the most powerful, potent drivetrains out there on the market, the question about reliability is always in the back of your mind. You don't want to drive something average like a Lexus or a Toyota. You want to drive something from the ultimate driving machine. Well, I'm going to give you a list of five of the ultra reliable engines that you can find in the BMW brand that probably won't necessarily break the bank, but will give you years of driving satisfaction. Let's get into it now. First, I'm going to share with you five of the most dependable engines BMW's ever produced, and they vary within the different generations, but I'm going to give you a sixth bonus engine, and that is the most reliable current generation BMW engine available. So the first engine we'll talk about is the M54. Now, not to be confused with the N54, which is the absolute opposite in terms of reliability, the M54, which is a naturally aspirated straight six engine. It can be found somewhere in the years of 2000 to 2006. And these engines are often found in the E46 325 variants, or as well as the E39 5 series cars. You can also find them in an X3 as well as Z4s. So these engines were somewhat more advanced. They were naturally aspirated, so they were a simpler engine without turbos. They were double vanos, so that's their variable valve timing system. All aluminum, that's head and the block. And I might add, simple doesn't always mean boring. As a matter of fact, you could get engines with 168 horsepower in a 320, 189 horsepower in a 325, and a massive 228 horsepower in the 330i. Lots of great engine selections and actually very dependable with a strong, smooth, silky smooth linear power band. Wonderful engines, and still to this day, many forums talk about the reliability of these engines. So the second engine on my list for most reliable BMW drivetrains goes to the N52. One of my personal favorites because it's the most advanced, most recent, naturally aspirated straight six engine available in the BMW market. It's the most developed, it's the highest output, and truly the most refined of all of the naturally aspirated straight six engines that BMW's ever produced. That engine called the N52 ran from about 2004 to about 2015 where it was finally replaced by turbocharged engines. These were often known to be found in the BMW E93 series as well as the E63 6 series cars. This engine actually replaced the M54 which we just spoke of, and it just so happens it's the first water-cooled engine ever to be made from magnesium and aluminum. So tweaks and tunes found these engines gradually developing over the years in the E90 generations. For example, in the 325, you found outputs ranging from 174 horsepower up to 201 horsepower, and finally 215 horsepower from the 325 in the E90 generations. Those were all the 2.5-liter displacement cars. What about the 3-liter engines in the 330? Produced either 215 horsepower or even up to 268 horsepower in its final and most developed form. These cars were very potent, and honestly, you didn't need a turbo because buying a 330 gave you all the performance, economy, and reliability that you could ever ask for, and a silky smooth drivetrain. This truly is one of my favorite BMW straight six engines of all time. So you're probably thinking, what about an M car? Could you even find a reliable M car engine? Well, as a matter of fact, that's my third choice, and we're going to talk about the E39 BMW M5 that features the S62 engine. This is one of my personal favorites, and a naturally aspirated 4.9-liter or close enough to 5-liter V8 engine that produces 394 horsepower and about 369 pound-feet of twist. Now, BMW's proven that they can create power and reliability all in one package, and this engine is known to do that. But there's some tricks in this engine as well. For example, 8 individual throttle bodies, 11-to-1 compression ratio makes it an extremely punchy, snappy engine, double row timing chain, which we all know can be a problem for those cars that run the single row of them skipping or braking and causing a catastrophic engine failure. This doesn't have that. We've got hollow camshafts, dual intakes, as well as a semi-dry sump system often found in many other BMWs, for example, the E60 M5 with the F1-derived V10 M5 engine. These engines were developed for the M5 and ran from about 1998 to up to 2003. And these engines are just so popular by enthusiasts because the performance, the simplicity, as well as they were created from a time when BMW really did over-engineer a lot of their cars. So you had a car that was very robust, dependable, and enjoyable to own for many years. So the next engine on my list of most reliable BMW engines goes to the M50. That's right, it is a naturally aspirated or normally aspirated inline six-cylinder engine. They came in various different states of displacement from a 2-liter, 2.4-liter, and a 2.5-liter. These engines produced anywhere from 148 horsepower in a 320, 185 horsepower in a... These engines produce power anywhere from 148 horsepower in the 2-liter up to 185 horse in the 2.4-liter and 189 horsepower in the 2.5-liter. These actually were the first engine that featured the Vanos, which is, again, BMW's variable valve timing system. They were double overhead cam, 4 valves per cylinder. They had an iron block and an aluminum head made it up. These engines were a true workhorse, and I really appreciated them. As a matter of fact, I've owned some of these, friends of mine have owned some of these, and really these are the epitome of straight six BMW engines. You can find these engines at E34, that's the 520 and the 525i's, as well as the E36 generation of 3 series cars, or you can find it in any of the variants, the i or ix or is models. These engines are truly the epitome of BMW durability, and I could truly attest they are great engines. So the fifth engine on my list for most dependable BMW engines goes to a bit of an older engine. That's right, you know, like the old adage, an oldie but a goodie, this really does apply. And we are talking about the M20 engine, which is an old school straight six naturally aspirated engine. These engines had varying degrees of displacements along the years from 2 to 2.7 liters and ran from 1977 all the way up to about 1993 when they were replaced by the M50 in the E36 cars. These engines featured a single overhead camshaft, naturally aspirated. It had an iron block with an aluminum head attached to it. No Vanos system, so it was old school. But they were basically found in the E30 generations of the BMWs. And you could find them in the 320, 323, 325s. And as well, it could be found in the 520 or the 525. That's the E28 generation of 5 series cars. This was from a generation when BMW was really honest. They did provide the true driving experience, the simplicity, durability, fun factor, and if you have to fix something, it's not going to break the bank. As a matter of fact, it's a real do-it-yourself car as well. The only unfortunate part is great cars of this generation are becoming very, very difficult to find and values are rising. So if you can find one, get your hands on it today. So that wraps up our top 5 list of most reliable BMW engines, but I also promised you a 6th engine as a bonus, the most reliable current generation BMW engines have found today. If you're to walk into a car lot today, you will find one in one of these cars. And that's an engine that you'll find in any of the 40 series cars, 540, 340, 440, you'll find them in the M40i's. In terms of the X3s, you'll find them in the M40i, the Z4s, the 40 series engine. It's also the same engine that's currently found in the current generation Toyota Supra. And that is the engine that BMW likes to call the B58. That's a 3-liter turbocharged 6-cylinder engine, twin scroll, of course. These engines expanded from what they learned on the N54, which was the tuner special, but you couldn't keep coolant in it. Then they moved to the N55, they learned a lot of tricks and they worked out a lot of the bugs. And now they're at the B58, which is a modular design, which is expanded from the N55 and is just far superior in many, many ways. But let's talk about some of the tricks this engine has up its sleeves. For example, this engine was actually manufactured since 2015, and in early generations, you could get it made it up to a manual gearbox, now unfortunately only to an auto. It does actually see a 20% boost increase from the previous generation N55 engines. It's also a closed deck design, meaning in other words, your coolant passages don't go up into the head area and compromise the gasket. No more blown head gaskets as you'll typically find in an N54 or some of the other turbocharged engines or even normally aspirated engines. It also is featuring a water to air intercooler. And as well, not just the double Vanos, which a lot of BMWs are utilizing, but it actually also uses a variable valve lift technology. Would you also believe it has a new technology as well loaded with engine-mounted heat encapsulation system, which also reduces wear and tear on really cold starts. And this engine can actually be found in so many cars and so many different variable types of outputs, from 322 horsepower up to about 380 horsepower, even up to the potential of 503 horsepower. The engine is proving to be very tunable, very reliable, robust, and if there is one engine in the current generation BMW lineups, this is the engine to have if reliability is your game and performance is also important to you. So I hope you enjoyed that list. So thanks a lot for sticking around to the very end, guys. I really hope you got some value out of the video. You really will want to subscribe to the channel because after all, I really am about the driving experience and the excitement and ownership of fun cars, fast cars, exciting and interesting vehicles. I don't really care about ho-hum A to B. I do in fact care about cars that make you happy at the end of the day. And if that is you and that's how you feel about cars and what automotive industry means to you, well, you'll want to follow my channel. So be sure to hit that subscribe button down there and a notifications bell. And I guarantee we will see you on the next one. Catch you real soon. Bye-bye.